Hi all. Starting the Amanco restoration now. Got a bit of work to be done. Some of the head studs are a bit manky, but probably be alright. But it's mainly cleaning up the threads and some of this off the sealing surfaces for all the threads and things that need doing. All the studs have got to be cleaned up. Anywhere there isn't supposed to be paint, I'll clean up and mask before carrying on painting. Otherwise it'd be a nightmare putting stuff back together, and I'm probably going to rub all this down so that I can do another smooth top coat. Likewise, flowers need cleaning up, a few fingerprints to buff out, but it's not bad. I managed to get the exhaust on the carburetor, which is for the heat. I managed to get that back on there, cleaned up the threads a bit. You can see I've rubbed this back so it's smooth, ready for painting, just to see what that'll be like. So I'll do that bit first. Crank guard, that hasn't seen anything done yet, but I might have a polished metal crank guard. I've seen another Amanco like that and it looked really, really good. So probably going to strip that back, handle it, rub oil onto it, and it will go that nice sort of brown colour. Bearings all look good. So really it's just cleaning things up, and then I need to get myself some more paint brushes and start painting Russian red or something. Yeah, so that's pretty much it for today. Also managed to get that stud which was stuck on the carb, got that out, put that back in the head. I might grind the valves in before I paint the cylinder head. Yeah. So I'm probably going to, as it's such a horrible day again, probably going to take this and put it in the house, paint it, and do it in the conservatory on the back of the living room. Yeah, so we'll see how we go today. I'm going to do a full back to bare metal and then repaint. Paint that's there isn't adhered well at all, it just peels off. So I'm going to get some of the Craftmaster stuff and get it done. So it's not going to be ready for King's Fold, but that doesn't really matter. I just want it to be right. Got the studs back in there. Yeah, so I'll have to go and get some paint stripper, primer and things now, I think. All means spending more money on it, but it's got to be done. It's got to look right. Yep. I think I have actually got some paint stripper in there, but we'll see. Anyway, so that's what I'm going to be doing for today, stripping paint, which is one of my least favourite jobs, but when I can get onto the painting, that's really nice. Just ordered some Craftmaster Amanco Carnation Red, which that should look really nice. Their paint is the same as I used on the Wolseley. It always gives a lovely finish. You don't have to try. Got some Plasticoat Red Oxide spray primer, which will save me a bit of time. I wanted a tin because I like brush painting, but couldn't get one, so. But it saves cleaning brushes and things like that. Managed to get a cheap nitrimoise tin because it's been dented. Wire brush. And an assortment of paint brushes. Different sizes so I can get into all the fine bits and pieces. Like round the edge of the spec plate. That'll allow me to do it neatly. Got some fine steel wool. Which will allow me to polish up the oilers and things really nicely. White spirit, brush cleaning, and the postman arrived. And they're 200mm, 20mm centres, and they're 160 I think, with again 20mm centres. So they're going to be the steerable ones on my trolley, and they'll be the back ones. They're going to be painted red, so they shouldn't look too bad. Yes, they're not cast iron, but They'll do nicely. Here's the drip feed oiler after being given a clean. I use wire wool soaked in vinegar to do this. That's the best thing for the job. Took it right apart, cleaned it up, and it's come out rather nice. So I'll show you it working. Set to about 6 drops a minute at the moment. Just a nice clean oil in there for that. So yeah, that works really well. Paint stripping's taking forever, but we are getting back to metal eventually. So yeah, it should come up quite well. Got some paint strip on the flywheels. It's starting to do its job. Right, so I think that's pretty much all I can show you for there. Not a lot going to get done today, just cleaning stuff up. Probably won't even get the block cleaned up today. But something I had noticed, the valves have obviously been ground quite a lot, so I'm hopeful that they'll be okay, but I'm not sure. I've also got one of the head studs has got a fairly well stripped thread, so I don't think that'll do. I'll try it first, but if it's useless then I'll take the stud out. Have to get a new one in there. So if anyone knows what thread they actually are, that would be great. This one. I'd like to replace them all, but I don't think I'd ever get them all out. Should look like that. There's the magneto. It's just been put back together just to keep the magnets together. Oiler and greaser that's been done. Luke, if you're watching, had a look through to find that check valve that's supposed to be there. Can't find that either, so perhaps you could have a look and see if you've still got that. It's definitely not on the carb already. So yeah, that's really all I can do for today. Nearly finished stripping one side of the block. But I'll get that finished tomorrow, I think. Yeah, so there we are. Not too much done today, but lots of little bits that needed doing. So I hope you enjoyed the video and thanks for watching.